Should I sue my bank for millions of dollars because of what they did to me in my foreclosure? My name is Michael Wasylik. I'm a Florida foreclosure defense attorney with Ricardo and Wasylik here in Florida. And together with my partner, Jason Ricardo, we help people just like you overcome foreclosure and debt collection with dignity. And today, what I'm going to talk about is whether you should sue your bank for millions of dollars because of the things they did to you in your foreclosure case. Now, I get a lot of people answering this question, and usually they're asking a couple of things. First of all, they're asking whether it's a good idea to sue their bank because they're afraid of what kind of blowback they might get in a foreclosure situation. But secondly, what they really want to know is, can they sue and get a lot of money out of a bank for doing things to them in their foreclosure that are wrong? Because most people feel like in a foreclosure situation, the bank has done something wrong that they should be able to sue for. So, the question that we ask in response to that is not whether you should, because in most cases, if you've got the ability to sue, in most cases, suing does give you at least additional leverage if you've got a strong enough case. And if it's a strong enough case, you might actually recover some money in that. So the question is can you sue your bank for any amount of money if you're in a foreclosure case or any other type of debt collection situation, or if you've just got a straight up mortgage and there's something you think they're doing wrong? And I'm gonna oversimplify this a little bit, but in most cases, the answer is no. In order to have a valid lawsuit, there needs to be a certain number of elements in place. And there are some people who can and should sue their bank back in a foreclosure situation or just a regular mortgage lending situation when there's been something done wrong. But in order to tell whether you have the ability to sue, we need to analyze three basic types of things. First of all, we need to analyze whether the bank had some kind of duty to you to do something or to avoid doing something. And the simplest way to think of that is, did they do something to you that they were not allowed to do? Or were they required to do something for you or with you that they failed to do? In most cases, you're gonna look for that duty in the context of a federal regulation or federal law that governs mortgage lending. So for example, you might have the Real Estate Settlement Procedures Act that talks about the ways in which the bank is required to process your mortgage loan. You might have the Federal Fair Debt Collection Practices Act, which governs the way the bank is allowed to collect debts. You might have the Fair Credit Reporting Act, which governs the way credit reporting agencies and creditors have to manage the way they report data to credit reporting agencies and to their customers. So all of those statutes have certain duties built into them. Now, those duties are worded very specifically, and federal judges and state judges like to define things very, very tightly. They like to play with the meanings of words so that they can be very precise about whether or not a claim exists. And for the most part, that precision in the definitions work to your disadvantage. They try to weed out those types of cases. So the question of whether a duty existed under federal law, under some other source of obligation, so for example, the mortgage contract itself, if there's some kind of duty that existed, then you may have a right to sue if that duty was breached. Now, the next element we look for is a breach of the duty. So once we establish that the bank had some kind of duty to you to do something for you or do something or not do something to you, the question is did they then violate that duty? Did they fail to do something for you or did they do something to you that was not allowed? So for example, if a bank commits debt collection violations that are prohibited by federal law, if they do something that is abusive or misleading, if they call your mother and tell her that tell your mother their son is a deadbeat, for example, that's something that would break federal law in most cases if the bank falls within the definition of a debt collector. And so, and again, that's one of the definitions that judges define very narrowly in many cases, and that's why you might have a case against somebody who does that, but because they're the original lender, you might not. So that's an example of a breach of duty where there's a federal law that prohibits a particular activity and they do it anyway. Other examples of things they're supposed to do for you, the Real Estate Settlement Procedures Act and Regulation X that flows from that require them to treat a loan mod application in certain ways. They're required to respond to you within a particular amount of time. They're required to give you certain types of information on a certain timeline once they have a completed application. So if you've done your part so that you have submitted all the information they need. Then the question is did they respond once that duty is triggered? Did they respond in the time that is required for them to respond? And if not, then maybe you have a lawsuit. Now, the third issue that we see is the question of damages. Do you have damages that flow from that breach of an existing legal duty? And the question is harder to answer than most people think. A lot of people think, oh, I've got these emotional damages, they cost me a lot of stress, I had to spend all this time and energy going through this process or suffering because of what they did to me. And the existence of damages, especially in federal court right now, is something that many cases are getting thrown out because they can't prove that they have the required category of damages. Not every type of lawsuit allows you to recover every type of damage. And so you have to be able to demonstrate some kind of actual damage that flows from the bank's breach of whatever duty they had to you, or the lender's breach of whatever duty they had to you. And that damage has to be real, it has to be substantial, it has to be documented, and it has to actually be caused by the breach. In other words, if you were already stressed out because you were behind on your mortgage loan and then they didn't give you a loan mod, you may or may not have additional stress that results from that. And the bank, their defense lawyer is going to say, well, look, you were already stressed. You already had terrible credit. You already had all these damages that had nothing to do with anything the bank did. It's all on you. And so you may get a case thrown out if you can't prove damages that flow directly from that breach of duty. Now, lawyers watching this video might recognize duty, breach of duty, and damages as a contractual analysis. You're right, I'm oversimplifying, but it is generally true that in order to have any kind of lawsuit against a mortgage lender, against a bank, you're gonna need to prove, you're gonna need to have that duty, you're gonna need to have a breach of that duty, and you're gonna need to have damages. Depending on the cause of action, depending on the claim you wanna raise, you may have different elements that apply. Now, it's also very, very true that you can't just sue a bank because you're pissed off. You can't just say, I'm just gonna sue them and just, we'll throw everything we can at them. You have to identify a specific factual basis for a lawsuit, and that factual basis has to fit within that pattern. It's like a key that fits a lock. The lock only accepts one key that's particularly configured to open that lock. And if your case is the key, the facts of your case are the key. And if the facts of your case aren't configured just right, they won't open the lock and you won't have a valid lawsuit. So if you're wondering whether you can and should sue your bank in a foreclosure context, you'll want to talk to somebody with experience in handling foreclosures and in counter suing, in filing suits against mortgage lenders and mortgage servicers. So what you'll want to do is you'll want to give us a call. There's no risk to you. It's a 30-minute appointment. And when you call, we guarantee you're going to leave with more clarity, more information, more certainty about what you need to do next and whether or not a lawsuit is potentially something that you might be exploring as a solution for your foreclosure problem. So I'm going to give you the number in just a moment. It is 352-567-3173. That's 352-567-3173. When you call, please mention this video, Can I Sue My Bank? And we will give you a free 30-minute appointment with one of our lawyers, either me, Mike, or my partner, Jason. We'll talk to you about your situation. We will help you analyze whether or not you have a valid lawsuit or a valid claim against your bank or mortgage lender or a debt collector. And we will tell you what we need to do in order to set that claim up properly, pursue it, and hopefully recover you some kind of settlement or even a jury verdict. So if you're interested in learning whether you have a claim, whether you can sue your bank, whether you should sue your bank, give us a call. Again, that number is 352-567-3173. My partner Jason and I are looking forward to talking to you. So call now, don't wait, get an appointment as soon as you can. Give us a call. Thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you on the next one.